Hello developers, welcome back to the channel. If you are developing single page application using Vue.js, then you will need Vue Router. Vue Router allows you to switch between pages without refreshing the page. Using that, navigation is very easy and nice in your web application. So today in this video, we're gonna learn how to implement Vue Router in the Vue.js application. By default, Vue.js is not shipped with Vue Router. To implement it, we need to install official Vue Router package. So now let's install this in the application. So in the terminal, I'm in the Vue application. So here I'll run npm install Vue-Router. Hit enter. This will pull in the Vue Router package in our Vue.js application. Now Vue Router is installed. Next in the editor. Now in the main.js, here we'll import Vue Router from Vue Router. Next, because this Vue Router is plugin for Vue.js, so here we need to specify to use this Vue Router in the Vue. So here we'll say Vue.use Vue Router. Our next step is to create routes. So here say const router is equal to new Vue Router, and inside here we create routes and say routes, and it has array of routes. So here we'll create our first route. So here say path is equal to home page, and component is, let's say, home. Now let's create this home component, home.view template script, and inside here in h1 tag we say home page. Now let's import this here, import components home. Now we have created a first route. Next we have to tell this view to use this router. So here it will say router. That's all we need. Now let's see this in browser, refresh, and it is working. In the app.js, which is the entry point of our application, let's clean this all which we have used in the last lesson. Now refresh. Now you can see it is working, but we cannot see any data right here. We cannot see this component rendered here, because in this component we have to tell where this component should render. For that he will say router-view. Now this home page will render right here in this route view tag. Let's go to the browser, and here it is rendered right here. Let's register one more route. Path is equal to about, and component is about. Now let's create this component about.view. Let's copy all of these here, and here we'll say about page. Next we need to import this in the main.js. I will say about and about, and we have used this component right here. Next if we go to slash about, and here we got about page. Now here you may notice that this hash in the URL, if you want to remove this hash from the URL, right here we'll say mod history, and this will remove the hash, and we can access about page without hash. Now you may see that if we add more routes, this page will get bigger and bigger. So instead of creating all routes here, I will create a separate file, routes.js, and here I'll say export default, and we're gonna cut this from here, paste it here, and let's cut this from here and paste right here. And final step is we're gonna import routes from routes, and we're gonna use that right here. Then we go to browser, refresh, and it worked the exactly same. Now next, let's create a navigation. We usually create navigation like this: anchor tag, href, and path, and then home. Again, second is about and about page. But here we should create links like this: router link, then say home, next to specific path, you'll say to home page. Next here say about and about. Let's go to the browser. Now you click on home page, we navigated to home page. On click about link, we navigated to about page. And pay attention right here in the refresh icon. It is navigating to pages but not refreshing the page. Instead using path in here in the to attribute, we can also use named path. Let's see an example of it. Right here we can say name is equal to home, and here we'll say name is equal to about. Now in the app.view, right here we'll say bind, here we'll say name is equal to home. Name is equal to about. Now let's see this browser. It is not working. We forget to bind here. Now it is working. Now let's see one more example of dynamic routes. For example, let's say we have another route. Path is equal to, and here we pass posts, and now we want to pass post slug. This slug is dynamic, it could be any string. For dynamic path, we specify here colon slug. Next, here we say pass component, post component, and name is equal to post. Next, let's create this component post.view and say template and script, and h1 tag post. Let's import this post from post component. Now here in the app, let's link this post. Next, to pass this slug parameter here, we say params in the object, and here we pass slug. So let's say any post slug. We click this, you can see post route and here the slug. And in the post component here, we can also access this right here like this: $route dot params dot slug, and here we print it right here. In the real life project, you will fetch the post data using the slug from the API, and we'll display that here. You can also access this slug using props like this. Props, I'll say slug. Now in the routes, here we need to specify props true. So now here we can say simply slug. It should work. Let's see this in browser, and it is working. Now what if you type any gibberish here? It is rendered, but it does not match any components, so it has not displayed anything. For that, here we specify one more route, and path is equal to star as a wildcard, and component is not found. Create this component, not found dot view, template in h1 tag, not found there, script. Next here, let's import this, not found, now refresh, here we get not found. We type any gibberish here, it's gonna render not found. For the other links, it is rendering the respective components. This is all in this tutorial. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.